In July 2006, the Winnemem Wintu tribe came together to hold their first coming-of-age ceremony since the 1920s. They gathered at their traditional ceremonial grounds on the McCloud River at the tip of the Shasta Lake Reservoir.
This here is an old village site. You know, the dance grounds that are here, the sacred rock that's over there, that where the house is. And all along here are sacred places that are all connected to this mountain right here that the men climb and come down and swim in the pools on the river.
This ceremony is being held for Winnemem Sisk Franco, who will spend 4 days on the other side of the river, sleeping in a cedar bark house, praying and learning from the elder women.
I'm almost done.
How long have you been teaching?
I just finished my 8th year.
Tribal members and guests make preparation for a joyful community celebration. But outside the comfort and familiarity of family and tradition, the non-Indian world presses in, making demands on this place and the people. For the Winnemem, this is nothing new.
This lake was designed, you know, way back in the 1915s. It was already thought of that that'd be a great place to put a lake. It could be the largest lake ever. And already our people had over 4,800 acres of allotment land on this river all the way down to Kennett and all the way up. And they got that 4,800 acres away from the Indians by promising to give them like land to live on. But, of course, it was during the war. Our guys went and fought in the war. A lot of the women who were capable went and worked in the manufacturing companies making war materials. And they just, you know, never, some of them never came home. And the ones who did come home to this. No home. All underwater. All the people gone. No place to go. It wasn't like, oh, we moved your folks over there. They live over here now. This should have been the like land to live on. Now we're asking to use it for 4 days. And they don't have the language to allow us the ability to use this land for 4 days without interruptions of modern society, of modern people's rights.
The U.S. Forest Service, which has jurisdiction over this area, has bowed to tribal, public, and legislator pressure to allow the ceremony to take place. But they refuse to insulate the Winnemem from interruptions by closing this small portion of lake. Officials cite concern over conflict of use. They say they can't limit anyone's rights in favor of anyone else and don't have the legal authority to make the closure. So they've created a voluntary closure. While most boaters are respectful, others ignore the request to turn around. One family parks their houseboat a stone's throw from Winnemem's bark house.
They'll be walking up past that boat. I don't know how long they're going to stay there, but it changes how you think, you know. Every little thing. I mean, it's like when you see an eagle. It changes what you think, you know. And here you run into a houseboat. That changes what you think. It takes you away from the eagle. Here you have these loud jet skis coming up and down, and we're trying to sing. Or you have these boats that have booze and party. No, I don't know if there's booze on that boat over there. And my daughter's going to be walking right by it. We already have problems with alcohol. I don't want to bring her into her womanhood with alcohol right there present. It shouldn't be nowhere here. And we should have control of it, the fact that it should be nowhere here. You know, and we don't. It's like, okay, we're taking a risk, we're taking a chance. And this guy over here, you know, he doesn't want to move. My mom and dad born on this river. My grandma was born on this river. On was born on this. I would have been born here too had this lake not been here. I might have been born right here had we been given the land to live on. You know, that is a connection to this land. Now, how many of them is born here? Their people born here. Their village sites are here. Their sacred rocks are here. You know, there's a definite difference. We didn't travel to another country to find freedom. We already had it here. You know, we weren't looking for any other religion. We had it right here. That's all we're trying to do is continue to express what was given to us by the Creator. We're not asking for exceptions. We're not asking for them to pity us or whatever. It's like, just let us do what we were put down here to do.
Members of the Environmental Justice Coalition for Water are working with the Forest Service to persuade people to honor the closure.
Out on the river, we have about 5 kayaks now, including the Forest Service, kind of intercepting boats and letting them know about the ceremony and why there's a closure and really why it's so important that boats don't come up here. About 90% are very flexible and are like willing to turn around, and then there's the 10% who will just, you know, say rude things and swear at us and, you know, just say really, just really ignorant things.
As darkness falls on the third day, 2 boats have cruised up the river. As they return past the bark house, there's concern in the camp. A Forest Service official tries to talk with one of the boats, but is ignored.
Hey, how you doing, man? We love America. How about you? Hey, it's our river too, dude.
As the boat passes the camp, the occupants hurl insults at the people on shore, while the Forest Service kayak falls behind. On the last day, the women of the tribe help Winnemem prepare for her swim across the river to the dance circle. But one of the boats from the previous evening returns.
What the fuck are you looking at?
And the situation becomes tense.
I did speak with the sheriff's office out there, and they're just going to use their authority to close this arm of the lake until 4 o'clock or so.
With the sheriff's department taking matters in hand, Winnemem can safely swim the river to take her place among her people. And the ceremony is able to proceed without further interruption.
Deep breath.
Okay. Very good. Very nice. Now you can touch your hair. You're going to join in on this ceremony. We're going to take your place as a young lady here.